RimWorld 1.0 is almost here. I can't believe it, and I cannot wait. I remember first buying this game about a year and a half ago and thinking this game could be amazing, and it reminded me so much of Dwarf Fortress, which at the time I was obsessed with. It's safe to say this game has replaced Dwarf Fortress to me, and now that it's finally nearing release, I am absolutely stoked. Anyway, I am by no means an expert at RimWorld, but I do know some useful tips for people that could help them on the RimWorld endeavors. So without further ado, here's another list of 10 important tips and tricks for RimWorld 1.0. Tip number one is kind of a workaround for releasing animals and training them to be released in combat. Why waste your time training the animals for release when you can just designate an animal zone and assign that animal to that zone? This is useful for specifically boomalotes and boomrats who explode when killed, so if you're getting attacked by a group of raiders or bandits or whatever it is that you're getting attacked by, just designate like a zone for a boomalope or a boomrat, assign them to that zone, and watch the fireworks. Tip number two is something I didn't even know until a few days ago, and it's kind of neat. Horseshoe pins require at least 5 tiles worth of space to use, but also make sure that you build a chair for the horseshoe players to sit in. It gives them an additional mood boost. It's extremely useful for keeping colonists happy, and it's a neat little trick that more advanced players may utilize. Hopefully new players will utilize this trick as well. Tip number three is aimed at beginners, and it's remember to build a roof over your stockpiles. It stops your items from deteriorating, and it will help out your entire colony in the long run, especially when you start the stockpile things such as like clothing, art, medicine, drugs, even weapons deteriorate when they're not like under like a stockpile with a roof. Just please build a roof over your stockpiles. It really helps out in the long run. Tip number four is a very useful one that I forget to utilize all the time, and I definitely need to stop forgetting it. This tip would definitely be useful for my current RimWorld series, Naked Lone Survivor, which you should check it out. While you're at it, hit that subscribe button. You will become a character in my series for doing that. Anyway, tip number four is don't recruit every prisoner you can get, only recruit the good skilled ones. The others can be operated on to improve your colonist's medical skills. It's a bit dark and twisted to do this, I know that, but it's for the betterment of your colony, and to be fair, they were the ones that probably attacked you. Tip number 5 is a bit of a nice trick to utilize when it comes to trading. Tradable items don't have to be in your stockpiles, they have to be in your home area. I thought for a long time that items had to be in your stockpiles to be traded, but I was wrong. The items just have to be in your colony's home area to have the ability to appear in the trading screen. Beware though, this does not mean your items will be tradable, okay? The other colony that you're trying to sell them to has to actually want to buy your items. It will not like show up unless they actually want to buy it, but your items will have a chance to show up if you have it in your home area. So just beware that if you want to have items, being able to like trade them, make sure they're in your home area and not like off someplace random. Like if they're laying throughout the map, what you can do is you can just lay down a home area on that item, and it doesn't have to go to your stockpile. You just lay down the home area and it'll just hopefully pop up in the trade menu. Tip number 6 is one that can be easily overlooked, especially by new players. It's do not build stone doors on the interior of your base, only the exterior. The interior of your base should consist only of wooden doors simply because of movement speed. Stone doors are very slow, and they will slow down your colony's work speeds a lot. With wooden doors, you still get moderate protection on the indoors area, but you also get an insane speed, okay? Do not overlook doors and movement speed, because this will save your colony in the long run too. Tip number 7 is a bit of an odd one that is a bit controversial throughout the RimWorld community. If you dig your base into a mountain, don't build stone floors or wooden floors, just smooth the stone. The smooth stone gives a +2 to beauty instead of the normal +1 that wooden or tiled floors would give. The reason for this is unknown, because in all honesty, wooden floors or stone tiles should look better than smooth cave floors, but in RimWorld, I guess that's different. So always use the smooth floors instead of building your own. This little detail could save your colony from a mental outbreak. Tip number 8 is another one that I forget to do a lot, but it's very important, and it's similar to tip number 4. In addition to capturing prisoners and operating on them, you should always rescue animals and operate on them as well. Euthanizing them can be a great way to improve medical skills. If an animal goes mad and attacks your colonists, just subdue it, rescue it, then operate on it. It's an easily forgettable like task to do, but if you remember to do it, you can get some pretty god-tier doctors. Tip number 9 is an event-based tip. During a cold snap, go out and fetch the dead unfortunate creatures. This is a very useful trick to get a lot of food for practically nothing. During the cold snap, most creatures on the map will die, which means there's a lot of corpses left out there to go butcher and eat. It usually wipes the map of creatures, to be honest with you. Pretty much nothing's gonna survive that cold snap. So you can just go out there, and if you ever look at like the new wildlife tab that they opened, onto the, like, the new version of the game, you can see, like, all the wildlife. There's a lot of wildlife out there. So, yeah, you're going to be loaded with food for a very long time if you get lucky enough to have a cold snap and this happens. Finally, tip number 10 is basic, but some players, especially new players, overlook it. When two colonists love each other, be sure to build a double bed for them to sleep in. It will yield a boost of happiness for both of the colonists. Always embrace love between colonists because it keeps them happy, and a happy colony is a successful colony. I hope you learned a thing or two about RimWorld from this video, and I sincerely hope you enjoyed this video. Leave a like and subscribe to see tip videos, and also to see my own RimWorld series, and possibly other series as well. And thank you for watching, and goodbye.